are live with Stéph and Shay. This is episode number 40.
Number 40.
We are ready to go.
We are.
Yes, yes, yes.
There you go. Waiting for individuals to join us in our live with Stéph and Shay. If you're new here,
yes.
I'm Stéph.
I'm Shay.
And people know us as Stéph and Shay. We have some really exciting things to talk about, which is exciting.
Absolutely is. So we are going to talk about how to de-stress over the holidays.
Ooh, super important.
Tips to keep you calm.
Yep. Yeah, yeah. Through the holidays.
Yeah.
Because the holidays can, for, you know, some individuals can have its moments of, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Some stressful moments. So how to if you encounter, you know, stressful moments, how to do something about it.
Exactly.
How to get out of it.
How to get back to that state of being calm, cool-headed,
right,
in control, and really getting back to your center and
homeostasis.
Yeah.
Right? So we're here. So as we get started, Andy's already with the program. We didn't even ask.
No.
Did we? Did we ask?
No, we didn't ask.
She just knows the program.
She knows the program.
Yeah. She doesn't know the third part. But
right.
That's okay. She can fill in.
Hi,
right?
Andy from Minnesota.
Hey, Andy. Good to see you.
And I'm sure
Dom's nearby as well.
And Letty is there as well.
Yeah. Hello, hello, hello.
Hello to the fam.
So who are you? And she goes, I know the drill. Who are you?
Where are you from? Yeah. And,
we got Christmas coming up next week.
We do.
Right.
We do.
So,
what are you doing for Christmas? Yeah. What is
your favorite ornament? No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. That's
close.
A joke.
Your favorite holiday tradition that you do at the holidays.
Oh, your favorite holiday tradition that you do over the holidays. You know, we need to answer the question too.
I know what mine is. That's what made me think of the question.
Okay. Okay, I got mine.
Yep.
But you go first.
Okay, why don't we say it at the same time?
One. Are we saying it on three or on four? If you can't tell, we're really competitive.
One,
two, three, and then we'll answer it.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
so
yeah,
on
yeah.
four.
Yeah.
Okay. So one, two, three, fondue.
Swiss fondue. Too many words. I was saying Swiss fondue. And I went, Swiss fondue.
So funny. I said fondue. So not surprised. So for sure. I'm Stefan Schifeidel. And I'm in Utah. And Swiss fondue for sure.
That's where I am too.
Yes. Yes.
I'm sitting right by you.
Wait. Apparently, you're in the same room as me, right? So Swiss fondue. I got to tell you about that while you're putting in the chat room. And by the way, if you just join us, let us know who you are, where you're from, and like where you're currently residing, right? Because where you're
from,
where are you from could be a very philosophical question,
right?
And give a lot of answers.
Like, where are you joining us from?
Where are you joining us from?
Yeah.
Right. Where are you right now? Yeah. Physically. And what's your favorite?
Holiday tradition.
Oh my goodness gracious. So let me tell you about, you know, my mother was Parisian French. She's no longer with us. My father was Swiss, also no longer with us. So I'm half Swiss, half French, right? My mom was very, very, very Parisian French.
Very.
I mean Chanel, head to toe.
Yeah.
If there's something Chanel, she had it. And I mean, Chanel number 5, she bathed in it every single day. It wasn't like squirt. It was like squirt, 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 squirt.
As like, only the French would do.
Right.
Yeah.
And I mean, she came into like a room and it was like Chanel number 5, right?
She's a gorgeous woman.
And anyway, so my father being Swiss, he was raised, you know, by a poor Swiss farmer. In a salt mining town in Switzerland. And anyway, his mother was a chef, not by trade, but very, very, very good cook. And my father learned everything about cooking from his mother, and I learned from my father. I was a little kid. Like, I was probably, I remember around 4 or 5 years old. You know, I'm going through that phase of what's that? You know, what are you doing? Why are you doing it? I don't understand. Help me understand. Explain this. And I did a lot of, my dad always told me I had a lot of questions as it dealt with cooking. So what my dad did is one day there was like, you know, imagine like the stove is like right here. And then the countertop was like right here, from your perspective, right next to it. And my dad would put, you know, with a little bit of buffer. He didn't want me like too close to the stove. Of course, he was smart, but he'd pick me up and he'd sit me on the counter, not on the stove, on the countertop beside the stove with probably about a foot of space, right, for safety. And he just let me watch. And I didn't realize that I just sat there and I watched. And I'd ask a lot of questions. And that's how I learned how to cook. And I learned how to cook a lot of traditional European dishes and just learn how to cook. Anyway, so get ready. Your mouth may water. And I apologize if you're hungry. You might get hungrier. So
I am hungry.
A traditional Kirschwasser fondue au fromage. It has three different types of cheese in it. So it's got an Appenzeller, Gruyere, and an Emmentaler. Appenzeller is kind of a medium cheese. Gruyere is very sharp. You may know about the Gruyere cheese. And then Emmentaler is a very, very, very mild cheese. So it blends together really, really, really well. And so anyway, the Gruyere, it's half Appenzeller, it's quarter Gruyere, quarter Emmentaler. Good, very specific.
with Swiss, so.
With a little bit of starch in it, white wine, loads of garlic, and one shot of cherry brandy, which is known as Kirschwasser in Switzerland. And you mix it up and it kind of forms all together. Andy says, oh my God, stop, I have a dairy allergy. I can't eat cheese anymore. So anyway, and you take...
You could live vicariously through us.
Yeah. So. And then you take nice fresh baguette bread or green apples. That's a lighter option. And a gluten-free option, yeah, these days. But anyway, and you dunk it into the cheese and it's like just a culinary treat.
So yum.
So
and then it's grown since then. I mean, you guys would always do the cheese. I don't think you guys did the three-course.
We didn't do the three.
That's more Americanized.
You can do that. It's just a lot.
Yeah.
We would usually do cheese is like the main dish,
meal.
Or fondue bourguignon, which is oil and the meats and the vegetables. That's its own dish. Or fondue chinoise, which is a broth with thinly cut meat. That's its own dish. Chocolate, like once in a blue moon. Yeah.
So now what we do is when we get together at Christmas, we do this, but we do three courses. So we do cheese, the oil fondue, and with, you know, different meats and vegetables, and then finally wrap it up with a chocolate fondue. So that's what we're doing this Christmas with my family.
But you never get full.
No, because it's so light. Because you get a bite, and then you have to like prepare your next little bite, and you're talking, and it's just more of like a
European meal.
The experience.
Where you start at like, well, in traditional European meal, you start at like 10 p.m. and you go like probably until like 2 o'clock in the morning, right?
Yeah.
we usually start at like probably 7-ish. But we go for a good 4 hours. Mm-hmm. So you're eating, you're grazing, like bit by bit over 4 hours. You don't really get full.
Yeah.
It's impossible to really get full.
It's a light meal. So that's my newer favorite tradition since I've been together with Steph. I mean, 17 years now. But my favorite tradition from my family is my dad gives me and my brother and now Steph and my mom, he gives us an ornament every year at Christmas. So I have a whole tree, like a little, you know, mini tree that's just filled with an ornament that I've received every single year from my dad. And he always, you know, puts a lot of thought into it. And he gets an ornament that's based on kind of what is going on in our life at that time. So I have a lot of, you know, like school books when I was in school and read a lot, or like a lot of sports, basketball, soccer, and then when we moved to the snow, we have like a Santa Claus doing a snowplow, like snow plowing. And
yeah.
So it's really thoughtful.
A razor OTB, like he got us that. Last year, he got us one which was custom made, which was when we got Wall Street Journal bestseller with our book. He had a custom made one that had a picture of us, picture of the book. And it said number two Wall Street Journal bestseller. So super, super, super cool. Awesome. Well, again, if you just joined us, who you are, who you are, who are you, where you're from, and what is your favorite holiday tradition?
We'll check the comments. So Andy's,
and then we'll get into it.
Yeah. Well, we're talking about how to, we're giving tips for a stress-free holiday. but let's check the comments.
Heather says Christmas PJs. on Christmas Eve.
Nice.
Yeah, cool.
Andy in Minnesota says making Swedish Spritz cookies.
Oh my goodness. Yum.
You're all about the cookies, girl. I love it. You're gonna have to share some recipes.
Let's just hop in the jet and head over to Minnesota and get some cookies.
Totally.
Seriously. Okay, bouncing around. Paul's in the house. Awesome. Paul is one of our Mindpower Coaching Academy alumni. Coaching Academy.
Paul Jensen. Because I see Paul McKee just joined us.
Paul Jensen's one of our Mindpower Coaching Academy alumni. He's a good friend, known him for years. And anyway, he's a recent alumni of Mindpower Coaching Academy. He just recently graduated and secured his first client, which is super exciting today, contract signed, doing the 12-week Mind Power Coaching methodology. And it's a $9,000 client, which is huge.
Congratulations.
Awesome. I got to give a big applause to him.
Shout out to Paul.
He followed the system.
Totally followed our system.
Our Mind Power Coaching Academy is a 12-week program that helps you become certified in what we do. You become a certified and licensed Mind Power Coach. It's a licensing program. So super excited. Paul's also part of our elite inner circle. So we're lucky to have Paul here tonight.
Thanks for joining us.
He's famous. He's big cheese.
What else have we got? We've got
Loris
likes, he's so, you're outside of Toronto. Cool. Yep. Favorite ornament is the mistletoe.
My man.
I love it. Favorite ritual is reminiscing about old jokes with family. Nice.
I love it. Hey, Alicia, good to see you
from
Michigan. Favorite tradition is wrapping presents and eating crab cakes.
Yum. Ooh. On Christmas Eve.
Send us some, please. Okay, cool. Hawaii Paul is here.
Awesome.
Hi, good to see you. Ephraim is here, Cedar City.
Is your favorite tradition New Year's?
He likes New Year's. Yeah, cool.
Awesome.
Veronica Ramirez.
Hey, welcome.
Veronica's an alumni from our Mind Power Breakthrough. From way earlier this year.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
Yeah. Hey, Veronica, come back and see us. We actually have a special offer for
alumni, VIP alumni. To rinse and repeat the program next year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Cool. If you're interested at any point in time, like you could reserve it now and then it's good for up to 2 years.
So you can take it to the next level again.
Yep.
Yeah, a lot of individuals are finding one time a year doing the Mind Power Breakthrough. By the way, everybody, that's our 6-week developmental program to help you get from where you're at to where you want to be, our Mind Power Breakthrough. Veronica's an alumni. We've got a lot of alumni here.
Yeah.
Tegan's an alumni. Fifi Barlow, Ephraim is here.
Yes.
He's an alumni. And a lot of individuals that are Loris and Mindy and
are going to be
Andy,
in
Misty,
the January.
You're going to be in our January group.
Yep.
Which is exciting.
Mindy said, hello from Utah. Scones for breakfast on Christmas morning is your favorite tradition.
Mindy,
awesome.
Honey and butter? Curious. Do you do honey and butter? Just curious there.
Yum.
Paul says, a Christmas tradition is making and drinking glögg, a Scandinavian drink, my peeps are Danish, that is made from muscatel, aguavit, oranges, raisins, cloves, almonds, and other stuff. You drink it hot, and after a few, you can fly like Rudolph.
I bet you could. Wow.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Awesome.
Super cool.
Donna's in the house. Hey, Donna.
Donna's a Mind Power Coaching Academy
alumni.
She was in the same cohort as Paul. She's also part of our elite inner circle.
Yes.
Got some famous people here tonight.
Yes, yes, yes.
Some of the more famous people in the tribe, in the community.
Cool.
Awesome.
And Andy says, send me your address. I'll ship.
Oh my goodness. Holy shnikes. Okay, cool.
Awesome.
Put like as in cookies?
Yeah. You have to tell us what your favorite are.
We're not picky. If you say this is a cookie that you need to eat, I'm going to say, yes, ma'am. Got it. Okay. So cool. Good to catch up with everybody. And I say we get into it.
Yeah.
Right?
Let's dive in.
Now, little housekeeping item.
Yeah. First, so we wanted to put out an ask.
Yep.
For all of you who have either read the book, Master Your Mind Power, or listened to it on audiobook, we are asking if you would so kindly leave us a review on Amazon so that we could get it out to more people.
Because I don't know about you all, but Shay and I, we make a lot of decisions when we buy stuff online by looking at reviews. put in the chat room, say yes in the chat room. If you, when you buy something online, if you look at the reviews, we know that to be true. And you know, what we're excited that so many people consider our book. And what if there's an individual, I don't know if this is happening, but we could only imagine, what if there's an individual where, you know, they want to see, you know, good amount of fresh reviews. And if the reviews there written by you, it'll literally help that individual to make the decision to get the book, right, which changes their life, and it impacts their family, impacts their church, impacts their community, their state, their province, their country, whatever, right? So literally a short and sweet review would be appreciated. And it, you know, if, of course, you've, and by the way, you don't have to have completed the book.
Right. It could just be of what you've read, what or you've listened read so far.
I don't know if you know this, but 80% of people who buy books, 80% don't make it past chapter one.
Crazy,
it's
huh?
It's a statistic that's insane. And so realizing that a lot of people may not have finished it, even if you can just, you know, based on what you've read so far, leave us a review. Not only, like I said, will it help an individual to feel comfortable to get the book and then to impact their life, but also their family's life, which is super cool.
Big time.
Short and sweet is fine.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be a novella.
Keep it easy.
Just keep it easy and simple. And we appreciate it. It's a big ask. So, yeah, just a little bit of an ask here.
Yeah, and you just go straight to Amazon, and there's an area that says, you know, would you like to leave a review? And it is pretty straightforward.
I can even give them the link. I'll give them the link in the chat room while you set us up for what we're going to be talking about.
Cool. All right. And so looks like we've got a lot of people here from Facebook and YouTube. Doesn't look like LinkedIn is connecting. At least I'm not able to connect online. So if you are joining us from LinkedIn, we are not able to see you. So apologies for that.
Sorry, but hello.
But you could always jump over to Facebook if that's an option, or YouTube, so that, yep, you know, you can, we can interact with you. And also, once we get to the Wheel of Mind Power at the end, which is our famous giveaway, you can be able to enter your name.
Let's tell them what we're going to be giving away. We're going to be giving away a Got Mind Power shirt.
Yes.
Which is going to be super exciting.
Super soft.
Super soft.
Love it.
Feels so
They're
good.
Great for workouts. They're great amazing. For sleeping in. They're great for whatever.
We're going to be giving away a leather-bound journal. Success Training Company is our parent company. So you'll be able to, you know, write in that and make it your dream journal. You'll be able to put down your notes,
your goals for 2022.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Important.
Very important.
Super important. Also, we're going to be giving away...
This is new. We're going to be giving away an audiobook of Master Your Mind Power. We have a code that we can give you and some instructions on where you go. So it's the complimentary code that you can get the audiobook.
Put in the code into, what is it? It's
audiobooks.com.
We'll make sure our team members give you the instructions.
And then finally, we're going to be doing
a free coaching session with Jada.
Yes.
Member experience, powerhouse of a coach. Love Jada. If you love Jada, say love Jada in the chat room, please, so that she can, you know, feel the love. She's our resident empath and our director of member experience, and also one of our coaches on staff as well. She's just a phenomenal coach. So today's about the holidays.
It is, yeah. I mean, it
Hanukkah's already passed, and you know, Christmas is to come. So We're kind of like nestled in between two of the more major holidays. When is Kwanzaa?
I don't know that.
I don't know. I'll find out while you're talking.
And you're doing the Amazon link too, I think.
I did. I put the Amazon link in there.
Oh, wow. You're fast.
I did. I am fast.
You're like a phantom.
So Kwanzaa is on December 26th.
Cool. Isn't that like Boxing Day in Australia?
I think so.
Yeah.
So we're nestled between Hanukkah, Christmas, Kwanzaa, and Boxing Day.
Yes.
So it's a good time to talk about things that are related to the holidays.
Yeah. So drop a hashtag be calm in the comments if you would like to learn how to be more calm this holiday season, right? Because, I mean, this time of year is supposed to be the most wonderful time of the year. Yet what often happens is it becomes the most hectic time of the year, right? When we're going from this event and that event and this our kids event and this holiday party and wrapping this and buying this and cooking this and it's a lot, right? And so you get to the point where you're like, what is going on? And you forget and you lose the Christmas spirit and the holiday spirit in what is supposed to be time spent with loved ones and reminiscing with each other and refreshing, renewing, you know, for the year and just getting together and celebrating.
I think about the movie Four Christmases with yeah. Vince Vaughn and is it Reese Witherspoon?
Reese Witherspoon, yeah.
I don't know if you've seen the movie Four Christmases with Vince Vaughn and Reese Witherspoon, but you know, they usually always like go and, you know, do a vacation over Christmas so they don't have to go and see their families, both of which have families where parents are split up. And anyway, so they make up some story and, you know, one of the mottos in the movie, which I'm not, I don't really agree with, but anyway, is you can't spell families without lies. And right. so they always lie about that they can't come because they're like inoculating, you know, babies in Burma or something like that.
Or making sock puppets for... you know, disabled
stuff like
children.
That. And, they're just like, and they really
they
just
make
travel.
Up all these stories.
They really just travel. And yeah. anyway, and it's so funny whenever he's like, you know, on the phone with his mom, he's like, krabab, hip hop, hop. And he's like, sorry, that's Merry Christmas in Burmese, mom. But anyway, point being is if you think about that movie, he's on the roof, you know, trying to install that satellite dish
for his dad of what he got him for
and
Christmas.
And then he falls and like, you know, the secret safe word is mistletoe. yeah. And he's like, he's laying in the bush and he's like, mistletoe, right? And, you know, anyway.
It's really funny.
It's that movie, Four Christmases, not only is it a good laugh, but it really is how, unfortunately, a lot of individuals, they spend their holidays, and it's full-on stress mode.
Miserable.
They got to be 10 different places. They've got all this stuff going on, and the reality is, tis the season.
Yeah.
For gratitude and for fun and for family yeah. and for enjoyment and good activities and things of that nature.
Exactly.
Not stress.
No, it's supposed to be, you know, kind of slowing down a minute and enjoying that time and you know, really enjoying it like we used to as kids, right? Where there was like magic to it.
Yeah.
Remember that, right? It was just so magical. So I love this quote from Charles Schulz, right, the creator of Peanuts and Charlie Brown, he said, Christmas is doing a little something extra for someone,
aww.
Right, which is a big part of the holiday spirit, right, is giving and gifting. Yep. And
it's supposed to be the most wonderful time of the year.
It really is.
Like, if you think of the song, and yet it's often the most hectic time of the year,
yeah.
right?
So let's
make it a beautiful, wonderful time.
Turn it back into what it's meant to be, and, you know, that time of joy and love and magic and spending time with loved ones.
And he says he's from Minnesota.
Ah,
he's from
cool.
Minnesota.
I did not know that.
That is super cool. I didn't know that.
Very
I
cool.
usually have like crazy knowledge in my head about things like that. That one I didn't
now,
know.
Now we know.
So yeah, let's talk about it. The reality is what usually happens to individuals, just so you get what happens, is they have a moment of stress and then they spiral. So something triggers the stress, probably overwhelm. Or you know, too much just happening.
Anxiety which, about yeah, all the things they've got to do.
Right. Or something doesn't happen exactly as they want it to, like the lights don't work or one bulb goes out and it's an old Christmas,
yeah.
you know, light
set
and the whole thing goes out and the string. Thank you. That's what I was looking for. The Christmas light thing, the string. and then there's a trigger and then they spiral. And so the reality is to be able to catch yourself whenever there's any triggering moment that causes you to feel anything other than feeling good and grateful. And, you know, that's just what it's all about. And you want to make sure that you're in the holiday spirit.
Yep.
And catching yourself from spiraling from a little trigger turning into the whole holidays are stressful. And you're supposed to be able to enjoy it.
Exactly.
And there's a couple of days off there. So it's a time to rest and recharge and whatnot. So we're going to teach you something which we call our blah method. And we created this many, many years ago for our clients.
One of our signature methods that, like Steph said, we created many years ago when our clients kept coming to us and they were in overwhelm, stress, anxiety. And we were like, there's got to be a better way. And so we created this method that will help you to be calm, cool-headed, and in control.
It was literally when the book launched, this was a portion of the book that a lot of individuals grabbed and it became all the rage. We were invited on multiple different TV talk shows and you know, news channel little spotlights
yeah.
and stuff like that. Because whenever our book launched, it was amidst the beginning of the pandemic and everything COVID, and people are all freaked out and, you know, just going into the supermarket and buying toilet paper in droves and definitely weren't cool-headed and in control.
No. And right? So when we were, you know, being asked to be guests on these shows, they wanted to know what's a quick, easy, simple tool, technique that people can do to get out of anxiety or overwhelm. So while we are specifically talking about this for the holidays.
Oh, it works year round.
Obviously, it works year round. So this is called our BLAH method, and it's B-L-A-H.
Yep. Big picture, it's breathe. We're going to talk about each in detail.
I'm going to teach you each one.
Breathe, look up, access a positive state, right? And handle it.
Yep.
Right? B-L-A-H, BLAH, right?
BLAH.
And why BLAH? It's whenever we create it, it's kind of like when you're in a BLAH moment, or you're having a BLAH day, or you're feeling blah because you're triggered by something or whatever, anything that's blah, well then use the blah method. Literally turn that negative state of blah into a positive strategy known as the blah method. That's how it's going to be easy to remember it. If I'm feeling blah, the blah method will actually work.
It'll get you out of blah.
It'll get you out of blah and into a state of feeling really good.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
So first part, we're going to dive right into it, okay? The first part, the B stands for box breathing, right?
Yep.
The B stands for box breathing. Now, let us tell you about box breathing. We as you know, our book was a 12-year research project, and we studied the most successful people and what caused the super successful to be successful and what caused the super wealthy to be so wealthy, and the people that were just high performers, what made them tick. And you know, what we found was, you know, something that was amazing that trauma room physicians do before they go into the ER whenever there's a crisis, was the same thing that Navy SEALs do before going into combat. Which is the same thing that a multi-millionaire, multi-billionaire does before they go into negotiate a multi-million-dollar or billion-dollar contract. Which is the same thing that professional athletes do right before they go and perform.
So we noticed this pattern and said, there's something to this.
There's got to be something to this. And then we, as we started to research it more, quote unquote from a medical doctor that we spoke to said, oh yeah, the box breath is a well-known breath that literally can cause an individual that has elevated blood pressure to literally bring their blood pressure to a safe, normal level. And what he said, quote unquote, he said, there should be no issues for an individual if they're doing box breathing for about a minute for their high number to reduce by 20 points. That means if somebody's at, let's say, 175 over 85, that they're probably going to come down into the lower 150s. That's a huge drop. That could be, for some people, a life-saving drop.
Yeah.
Right? Because high blood pressure is, you know, and high elevated heart rate, which is known symptomology that happens when an individual is stressed out or overwhelmed or anxious, literally can wreak havoc on the body, and it stems from the mind. Right? So we can tap into the mind, change what's going on inside of our mind, which changes the physiology. Right. Which is exciting.
Right.
So in the breathing world, if you want to talk about the breathing experts who talk about breathing to be like shapes, like the line breath, the triangle breath, they'd call this the square breath, right? Because it's like a square. I don't know if you know this, but breathing has four parts. There's an in-breath, there's a hold, there's an out-breath, and there's a hold. And so the reason why it's called a box breath, or also known as a square breath, is because the in, the hold, the out, and the hold are all of equal
time
lengths, or lengths of time.
Yeah.
Now, before we get into, we'll show you an image, and before we get into it, and we're going to do it together, right? This is so important, so important. We just read an article just the other day of Mac Jones. I don't know if you know who Mac Jones is, and Mac Jones is currently the starting quarterback for the New England Patriots. And he's the individual who replaced Tom Brady,
right?
The greatest of all time, the GOAT. So anyway, he what ended up happening in the article is it was his first start, and they said, "How did you stay so calm, cool-headed, and composed, getting ready to take your first snap?" in the NFL and replacing and trying to fill the big shoes of Tom Brady. And he says, oh, no problem. He goes, I was doing box breathing. I was box breathing all the way up to the line and getting ready to do the play, all the way up until I was doing the play and all the way through the play. And I told Shay, I said, again.
See?
I don't know if you've ever heard the concept that success leaves clues, right? And so the reality is, if, you know, multimillionaires and billionaires, trauma room physicians, Navy SEALs, professional athletes, they all do box breathing to get into a place of homeostasis and calm and cool-headed. Why the heck aren't we using it?
Why aren't we using this in our everyday, day-to-day life of everything we're doing throughout the day? Why not? It's there for us to use. It's free. All we got to do is just put it into practice. So, yeah, I learned of the box breath the first time was in 2001-ish. When I was on a mountain biking excursion with my friend, and it was a 16-mile downhill ride. And in the first 5 miles, I launched over the handlebars and like Superman over and hit the ground. And I won't, you know, spoil the whole story. It's in the book. But I had to go to a clinic and ended up, you know, having to get some work done. And I'll just say that I was very... My breathing was very erratic and almost hyperventilating. So the doctor on site, she didn't tell me it was the box breath. She didn't go into all the details. She just said, you know, breathe in through your nose, hold it. And she just said, follow me. And she was breathing in through her nose, holding it, breathing out and holding. And it calmed me down and kept me from passing out.
Yep.
So super, super, super useful, super important, and it's really easy to do.
So if a Navy SEAL can use it before going into combat, don't you think it'd be beneficial when you're feeling a little stress or overwhelm around the holidays or any time of the year? Of course, right? Of course, absolutely. So we're gonna put the picture back up onto the screen.
Where did it go?
Right, should be right there, maybe not.
Not there.
Okay. So we will. Let's see. Pull this back up.
There it is.
Right there. Okay, cool. So what you'll notice, and I know the bottom part of it is a little bit cut out, so we'll just have to tell you what that says. Let's see if we can get it up on there. Not so much. Okay, anyway, so the in-breath is, you can see it on the left side of the screen, and then there's the hold on the top part of the square. There's the out-breath on the right side of the screen, and then there's the hold on the bottom part. So the only thing cut off that you can't see is the word hold.
It just mirrors the top.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so anyway, this is a good representation of how every component of the breath is of the same amount of time. Let me repeat that. Every component of the breath is of the same amount of time. So before we get into doing it, we have to talk about what diaphragmatic breathing is. That means being able to breathe to the point where you can expand your lungs. You can literally, your lungs, as they fully expand, will push down your diaphragm. And then when your diaphragm pushes down, it'll make your gut area push out, right? Don't worry about it. Nobody's looking at you. It's all good. Like, this is just for the purpose of breathing, okay? So literally, you want to really, like, feel it, like, extend out, right? Really extend out whenever you're breathing. You can't do this hunched over. You want to be able to be sitting back.
Or standing up.
Yeah. Yeah, good point. You can do the standing up as well. And everything's through the nose.
Everything is through the nose. The breathing in through the nose, holding out through the nose, holding, right? All the nose.
A little bit of science is that when the breath is going in through the nose and the air is going in through the nose, your nasal cavities and sinuses and nasal passages, they're we won't get into the anatomy of it, but we'll just say anatomically designed for you to be able to produce nitric oxide from the air coming up through your nose, and it dumps that into your bloodstream. Nitric oxide is great for you to be clear thinking, right? And for you to have energy and just to feel good.
Yeah, because let's face it, when you're in a state of anxiety, you're not thinking clearly, right? No, your thoughts are all over the place. You're foggy thinking. You've got elevated heart rate, your breathing is erratic, and you're not going to get anything done. You're not productive. You're just mush, right? So this gets you back to
homeostasis.
Calm, cool-headed, and in control.
Yeah, very, very, very important. So you want to do diaphragmatic breathing and slow. By the way, here's how most people breathe. Very shallow. Upper lungs. Yeah. Most people don't even use their lower lungs. Very shallow.
Mm-hmm. Right? So they're not fully getting all the oxygen that they could.
No, you can really get it deep down into your lungs to the point that it expands. It pushes, your lungs expand, pushes against your diaphragm, making your belly area, your gut area push out.
And don't worry if you're not there right away. Keep with it. Keep practicing it. It is, believe it or not, even though breathing is a vital function for us to survive, a lot of people don't know how to breathe properly. Mm-hmm. Crazy as that sounds. So practice this and stick with it, and you'll get it down.
Those of you who know our morning routine for mental toughness, also known as our morning activation meditation.
Yeah.
Or did I get that right? The order, yeah. Right? It obviously, that breath is, and if you know about it, it's in our book, and we talk about it all the time too. That is what's known in the breathing world as a line breath, where it's all through the nose like this.
That's for
it's
totally
a line because there's
purpose.
No hold. There's no hold between the in and the out and the in. A totally different purpose. That's really building a lot of energy in your body. Do not do that if you're stressed. You're already high energy enough. You don't need to be more high energy.
Correct.
It'll exacerbate the stress.
Yeah.
You need a little bit more of a centering, calming breath, which this is.
The box breath, you might not want to do it first thing in the morning because you might want that uplifting energy, whereas the box breath is more calming. It would be good to do right before bed.
Or mid-afternoon if you're stressed.
Yeah, you know, sometimes there's those... Whatever,
or if you're stressed in the morning.
Yeah, it's true. Whatever point is for you, you're stressed or anxiety, you have anxiety, then do the box breath.
And you want to normalize.
Yeah.
Right? So it's kind of like this. Shay will count. I'll do it. And then we'll do it together. And then we'll move into the next part of the blah method.
Yep. Okay? So remember, it's all through the nose, right? All through the nose. Yes.
Okay.
Good. So first, exit or that thing. Yeah.
Exit the air. Good.
Empty the lungs. There you go. Okay. Breathe in through the nose. One, two, three. Hold. One, two, three. Out through the nose. One, two, three. Hold. One, two, three. Good.
That was one.
How do you feel?
I feel great. That was only one. Round around the square, the box.
Right.
There's one box breath. And I feel more centered. I feel much more centered. Now, notice, because everybody's used to rapid breathing, you need to don't blow it out fast. You want to
slowly
let it come out, just like you don't go, no, it's kind of like this.
Hold, and then slowly out.
Right. Super important.
Yeah.
Okay, Facebook user said, I need to
Pearl.
Do the afternoon in the, I think it is Pearl.
Yeah.
Said I need to do this in the afternoon. I mean, well, do it whenever you need to feel centered.
Yeah.
We recommend the line breath, which is part of our morning routine for mental toughness, to activate your mind. It's a good activation meditation to do in the morning, like right when you wake up. Like I do it right when I wake up, within minutes of me waking up. This is something that I do when I start to feel overwhelmed, which could happen mid-morning.
Right.
Or shortly after lunch, maybe.
Or Pearl, if you're, more anxious or, overwhelmed in the afternoon, then, yeah, do it in the afternoon.
Danielle Capelli said, hi, Danielle. Pleasure to meet you. It's amazing what breathing exercises can do, for sure. It's literally one of the secrets to what the super successful and the most highest performing performers do every single day. So important. Breathing. And we're not even done. We still got three other parts that's going to help you de-stress.
Yes.
But it's funny. This reminds me of a story. There was a story of an individual who wrote a letter to Thomas Edison and said, Mr. Edison, very formal back in the day, of course, said, Mr. Edison, what is electricity? And he wrote a letter back to this individual and sent it via courier to her. And the response said, I don't know what her name was, but let's say Miss Smith. Miss Smith, electricity is. Use it. That's it. That's all his response was. She said, what is electricity?
He said
electricity
is.
Use it. And so the reality is, it's the same thing. Breathing is. Use it. It's ripe for the taking. It's there. It's God-given. It's free. It's all around you. You just have to do the exercise and your world will change. We had a client real quick before we go into the other steps that literally he was struggling from high blood pressure. And he didn't want to get on a whole bunch of blood pressure meds and whatnot. And some individuals, maybe that's, you know, best for them if that's what their medical doctor recommends. But for him, he just didn't want to do it. And we supported that for him. And we're like, have you ever tried box breathing? And he was like, wait, what? And we're like, box breathing. Taught him box breathing. He started doing it 3 times a day. His blood pressure was like, what, 180 something, like I think in the mid 180s, maybe 185. Yeah. I don't have my notes in front of me from that, but and that was the high number. And then the low number was what, mid 80s, sometimes up to 90?
Yeah.
By the way, high. Newsflash.
It was high.
High. And so he started doing 3 rounds of box breathing. He did 3 rounds a day. And all he did is he did 3 rounds 3 times a day. So he literally went around the box 3 times for a session. It takes about a minute, yeah? Maybe a little bit longer if the length of the side starts to increase. He did that 3 times a day. And within a few months, literally, and as of the last time we spoke to him, which was last week, his blood pressure's around, like, literally high 110s to mid 120s. Over maybe like 70-ish.
Yeah.
Somewhere around like, does that sound about right? Yeah, somewhere around 70-ish. And by the way, huge. His doctor, his cardiologist was like, what have you been doing? He was like, box breathing. And this doctor, she didn't know about it. And she went, what is that? He taught her box breathing. Now she's teaching it to her patients as a natural approach first before having to go to other measures to help an individual with their blood pressure. Think about it.
Yeah.
When you're all worked up, your blood pressure shoots up, your heart rate shoots up. And so there becomes a real physiological thing happening when you're stressed.
Absolutely. Yet we all can get in control of it and get it back to homeostasis, get it back to center. So super powerful. Cool. So
let's do one together.
Do it all together.
We're just going to do one round. Let's do 3 rounds.
Yeah, let's do 3 rounds.
Let's do 3 rounds. You ready?
Of 3 seconds each.
We're just going to do 3 seconds per side.
Steph will do it with you and I'll count it.
We're going to do it together. Cool?
All right.
Okay.
So again, go ahead and empty out your lungs. Exhale. Good. Now breathe in through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Out through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Good. In through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Out through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Good. In through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Out through your nose. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3. Done. Good.
I feel so chill.
Let us know in the comments, how do you feel right now?
How do you feel just put it in the chat room. We want to feel how you feel. We want to hear how you feel. I can feel how they feel.
Are you floating
right now? I'm floating right now, kind of floating.
I can tell.
It's awesome. Yeah, let us know in the chat room. So that's the box breath. That's box breathing. Feels relaxed. Good.
Good.
Less tense. Yes. Already. Yep. Cool.
Beautiful. That's what we want to hear.
Super, super, super awesome.
So relaxing. Good. I think that's Pearl.
Huge. Feels so good. Good.
Love box breathing. Awesome.
It's huge. So important. Danielle says your skull breathing technique has profoundly changed my life. That's the line breath that we do in the morning activation.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And thank you for that feedback. Thank you. Wrote glad a thanks in the chat room. Glad it's helpful. That's why we do what we do. We're here to help people be the best for themselves and make a positive impact.
I love Loris's response. Relaxed and cosmic. Yes.
Cosmic, brother. I love it. Sweet. Okay, cool.
Awesome.
So that's part one. Part one is doing box breathing. Okay. Yep. The next ones are going to happen pretty quick, right?
Yeah.
And in terms of understanding what's going on with it. So B and blah method, box breathing.
Yep.
Then the L. Let's talk about the L. What's in the L?
The L is look up. Yep. So you just look up. And what's happening here from a neuroscience perspective is when you're looking down, you're either locked in your thinking or your feelings.
There's something that's well known in the neuroscience world that I don't know if you know this, but if you think about all of our sensory based organs, the one that has the closest communication to the brain are the eyes. So when I say sensory based organs, ears are for hearing, mouth is for tasting,
nose is for smelling,
eyes are for seeing. And by way of the optic nerve, there's the closest connection between the eyes and the brain. Ergo, there's a connection between what's going on with your eyes and what's happening in the brain and vice versa.
Yes.
So when an individual's looking down, then they're in feelings and or thoughts, which can enhance the
anxiety, the overwhelm,
whatever it is. So when you just look up,
you get out of your thoughts or your feelings.
And by the way, I don't mean like a neck movement.
Just pick your eyes up.
Just eyes like
just
this.
Eyes up.
Eyes up.
Because if you take your whole neck or your whole head, now you're not up in the visual plane as much. So you just need to take your eyes up.
So take your eyes up. This is really, really important. So what you can do whenever you look up, you can kind of look up, do this, right now while listening to us, you can kind of like look up and then take your hands out in front of you like this, and in a very calming way, wiggle them very gently.
So you're bringing your hands, I'll describe it linguistically in case you're not seeing us. It's imagine football goalposts. Right.
And if you need to look at Shay.
Yeah. If you can see me, then look. But if you're listening just to this auditorily, then it's like you're gonna have goalposts on the outer part of your head, near your ears, but out, lateral to your eyes, and you wiggle your fingers and you
very
can
gently,
see them.
Very gently.
Right. You're still looking up.
This ensures you're in peripheral vision, by the way.
But you can see your fingers wiggling. This is in your periphery, and you're in peripheral vision.
Which we call, in the book, we call mind power state.
Mind power state.
When you're in peripheral vision looking up, this is mind power state. This is literally the gateway to mental toughness and emotional resilience.
Say that again?
This is the gateway to mental toughness and emotional resilience. By literally doing nothing in your mind from a self-talk standpoint, and literally just, it helps you to clear your head, clear your feelings, clear the calculator, so to speak. So look up and make sure you're in peripheral vision. Test it by putting your hands up.
What it does is it expands your awareness.
Which expands all opportunities, right? So box breathing, right? And by the way, when I start my box breathing, I'm already looking up. And I can see peripherally, I can see a window over there, I can see a fan over there and a doorway over
there. Try it. So look up, and then, yes, you can do your fingers, but take your hands away.
So that you can look for other things
peripherally. Notice what do you see in your peripheral, right? Like, I can see a window over there, I can see Steph over here.
That's me. Hi.
And further I can see a door, and then further I can see windows and our Christmas tree way over there, and I can see heads. Steph's head is moving around with my hand. Yeah. So try it. See what you can see in your periphery.
So yeah, look up and then expand your awareness, and then notice what you can see in your periphery. That's the L part. And so here's the thing. There's been studies that have shown that it's impossible to hold a negative state in consciousness while you're in peripheral vision.
Yeah, pretty
really
cool.
Cool, right? So utilize that. What do you think professional athletes do? When we studied professional athletes, we realized that the highest performing professional athletes were constantly in a state of peripheral vision.
Oh yeah.
Right? Their foveal focused vision, obviously, on where they were going, but their peripheral vision was way expanded.
That's how they can see other players coming at them, or the open spot on the field of where they're gonna throw the ball, right? They're looking at everything, but they've got their focus, but then they've got their expanded awareness. I mean, think about professional car drivers, right? Race car drivers, they're going, 200 miles an hour?
Yeah, they're probably not, looking around much
looking,
like that. They're using their peripheral vision.
Because every movement that they do, that takes their eyes off the road, plus a jerky movement like that could make the whole car move, right?
A football quarterback, sorry to go like into jargon, but a football quarterback, it's called standing in the pocket. And whenever the pocket starts to collapse and they step forward in the pocket, you don't see them looking around. They're using their peripheral vision to see when the pocket's collapsing, and then they're stepping forward. or a football quarterback, American football, where they're what's called looking off the safety, where they're looking in this direction, making a defender to think that they're going to throw in that direction. In their peripheral vision over here, they see who they're actually going to throw it to, and then last second, look over here and throw it. I mean, well-known technique is activation and utilization of the periphery.
Yep.
So in your peripheral part of your vision.
Yeah, now
so breathe.
Yes.
Look up
and
while you're in peripheral vision.
Go into peripheral vision or what we call the mind power state.
Yep.
High level executives, CEOs utilize this state on a daily basis.
They look up and go into peripheral vision.
To have more ideas, to be visionary, to have more solutions, ideas come to them while in the state. So it's a lot of times I'll walk into Steph's office and he's just like this. And I'm like, oh. He's in mind power state. I'm going to let him be.
It's what Steve Jobs called thinking time.
Yeah.
Where he would just sit there and think. And he would look up and go into peripheral vision. And that's when ideas would come to him, like the iPhone.
Yeah.
So very important stuff.
Super, super, super important. Utilize it. It's free. It's there. It's within you. You just got to do it.
Number three, the A. So we covered the B. We covered the L. Let's cover the A.
A is access a positive state. Like gratitude.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Did you know that it's impossible to hold a negative state in consciousness while you're in a state of gratitude? I mean, try thinking about something you're grateful for right now and like really bathe in it. Try it. You could try it. Do this with me. Think about something you're grateful for.
Really feel.
Okay, I'm going to do it too.
That gratitude.
You might notice some shifts on my face.
Just bathe in all of that gratitude. See what you saw, hear what you heard, feel what you felt. Of all that gratitude.
Okay, now try to get pissed off.
Try it.
I can't. Like, I'm still thinking about that thing that I'm grateful for.
It just doesn't work.
It doesn't work. It's impossible to hold a negative state in consciousness while you're in gratitude. So what you do is you're, by the way, this is happening very fast. I know we're teaching it over time because we're making sure that you understand every component of it. And you know Shay and I are really big on how. A lot of people out there in the development world, they're like, yeah, practice positive thinking. Good luck. And, you know, Shay and I are like, oh, practice positive thinking by when you have a negative thought, asking yourself, what do I want instead, and then focusing on it. You know we're big on how. We're big on steps. We want to make it practical, pragmatic, and that you get the application of it, and it's easy to do and easy to use, and that you'll always use it. Same thing. It's like, you know, whenever it comes down to it, a lot of people talk about, you know, gratitude, and it's a nice thing. But there's a lot of science behind it.
Big time.
The reality is there's a lot of science behind it, and it's impossible to hold a negative state in consciousness while you're in gratitude because it's two different parts of your brain. Different neural networks would have to fire, and gratitude's so powerful, it just overcomes that negative state.
Yeah, that's why we do this on a daily basis when we do our 3x3, you know, morning routine, right? Because it's so, so, so powerful. We talk a lot about gratitude in the book. We have a lot of excerpts and research in there if you want more.
It actually changes your biochemistry. It'll actually change your biochemistry, which is cool.
Yeah, think about that for a second.
It's not just spiritual. It is. It's not just mental, which it is. It's not just emotional, which it is. It's also something that affects the physical body, you see. And I think that's pretty exciting. It dumps all of the feely-good chemicals into your bloodstream. Dopamine, serotonin, right?
Yeah.
All that good. Endorphins.
Endorphins, all
makes the you feel good.
Yeah.
Makes you feel good.
Yeah.
Yep. So like I said, you know, you're going to see how all this is happening very quickly. We're teaching it so that you get all the components of it. But it's literally like this so far with what we have. Breathe, look up, and then access gratitude. This is for me. If I'm in a stressful moment, which I just was literally yesterday, had a very stressful moment. I wanted to make sure it happened before bed. I wanted to make sure I could get to sleep. And so I did Blah Method. Yeah, we actually practice what we preach, right?
Use it ourselves.
And no, we're not perfect. We're just like you. And we experience stress. We experience overwhelm. We experience anxiety, sure.
Yep.
But we do something about it. We don't just sit in it, right? We do something about it. And Blah Method is a great go-to. So it's like literally I had the stressful moment and I sat down. For me, I like to sit down in a comfortable chair. And I immediately, as I started box breathing, I looked up. So I looked up, went into peripheral vision, started the box breathing. And then I did three rounds around the box. And then I was like, what is something I'm grateful for? It came to me. All of a sudden, a shift happened in my body. Yeah. And literally, I could feel it. So then that's BLA. What is the H?
The H is handle it. Right? Now you've gotten yourself from anxiety or panic or overwhelm into a calm state. So now that you can think clearly and your breathing is good, now write down all the things that are swirling around in your head or were swirling around in your head before. You might not even remember what they were, which is okay. But write down whatever it is that's got to happen and then prioritize it. The interesting thing is if you ever ask somebody who's overwhelmed, well, what are you overwhelmed about? What do they reply?
Everything.
Right? So you can't think about everything. You can't possibly do everything. So you've got to chunk it down and write down specifically what, you know, break it down. What is everything and list it out.
Or what am I anxious about? Right? What am I anxious about?
Yeah.
Or what am I stressed about? Right?
Now, so that the list doesn't put you right back into overwhelm, quickly prioritize it and just take the top three things.
That's
top three things, and then put the rest of it away and just take those three things, put it on a post-it note. We get more into prioritizing and being productive in module 5 of our Mind Power Breakthrough.
Yep.
So for now, just pick the top three things that you got to do and put the rest of the list away so you're not even tempted to go back into overwhelm and repeat the whole cycle.
Stop
right?
Stop trying to do 483 emails. Stop trying to do 483 tasks. Stop trying to do 483 projects. Like literally whenever it comes, meaning in a day. And the reality is that the super successful that are the super wealthy, they focus on at most three major projects a day is what we discovered. And what we've also discovered by studying the super successful is that the billionaires focus on
one
major thing that day.
That's right.
Yeah, could have a series of components and parts and tasks and whatnot, but one major thing that they're focused on, right? And so super, 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 super important. So that's handle it. Now, let's talk about that a little bit so you understand the different, you know, varying things that could happen in the handle it bit. If it's overwhelm, like Shay said, make a list, prioritize it, pick the three most important, handle it, get to work. If it's stress or anxiety, then what you need to do in the handle it phase is handle the stress or the anxiety, which works for the overwhelm too. One thing that we'll do is we'll say, what do I want instead? And for me, it's like, if I'm feeling stress or anxious or overwhelmed, like, what do I want instead? It's like, I want to be calm. I want to be relaxed. I want to be in control. I want to be calm. I want to be relaxed. I want to be in control, which is why we even put this, and it's even in the book. You can feel free to take a screenshot if you wanted to. It's probably a better image. Is it our book? Because you'll actually see the hold part. But whenever it comes down to it, you know, you see the calm, relaxed, and in control in the middle.
Yeah. So that's a mantra that you can
It's a good mantra you can do. Which is what you want instead of the overwhelm, the stress, or the anxiety.
So what you're doing there is you're jamming your internal self-talk of, oh my God, I got to do this. Oh my God. Right? All the freak out, whatever's going on, all the voices that are going on in your head. And you're just jamming the negative self-talk and you're reprogramming yourself with calm, cool-headed, in control. Or that says calm, relaxed, in control, whichever works.
The BLA, that part of blah already, has already put you into an optimum state.
Yes.
Already into homeostasis, already feeling
your biochemistry has already changed.
It's already changed.
Yeah.
The H is handle whatever it is you need to handle. And what's so important here, so many people, like Shay said a moment ago, they try to handle things from a place of overwhelm, stress, anxiety, and they don't do very good.
No, they're just frenetic, and they're going all over the place like a ping pong in a ping pong game.
Yeah.
Is that what it's called?
Or a pinball.
Pinball.
What about a pinball in a pinball machine?
Yeah.
Ding, 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 ding. Yeah.
That's like what's going on in your head and your energy, and it's frenetic, and you're just not getting anything done.
By the way, your heart rate's elevated, so you understand what's happening with overwhelm, stress, and anxiety. Heart rate's elevated, blood pressure's elevated. So now in that stress mode, there's going to be a blood flow in that moment of stress at that moment. Blood flow is going to go out to your limbs. Right? Think about it. Fight or flight response. So blood flow is going to go out to your hands. It's going to go out to your feet. Why? Hands, so you can fight.
Mm-hmm.
Feet, so that you can fight, right? If you're kicking, right? And where it's not is in your brain. So you're not doing a lot of logical thinking. You're not thinking straight, as a lot of people would say. And so the reality is that's a bad time to make decisions. That's a bad time to problem solve, right?
Big time.
And so that's why it's important to you do the B, breathe, the box breathing, L, look up, peripheral vision, A, access gratitude. And that's what we mean by then you're prepared to H,
handle it.
Right? And so understand, what do I want instead? I want to be calm, relaxed, and in control. Say that to yourself, calm, relaxed, and in control. And if it's stress, well, by now the stress is gone. If it's anxiety, anxiety's gone. If it's overwhelm, make a list, prioritize, pick three, get to work. That's it. This is game changing. And I mean, I have to tell you, we hear from so many individuals all the time, almost every single week. I will say sometimes multiple times a week, somebody saying, thank goodness for the blah method. Literally, it's helped me. It's helped my kids. We have so many of our members in our community who have taught the blah method to their kids to help them no longer have anxiety.
Big time. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huge.
It's useful. Just got to use it. Got to use it.
Yep. So good. That's the blah method.
Yeah.
Put in the chat room if you think this was beneficial.
Yes.
If you plan to use it and you know, whatever you enjoyed most about it.
Yep. And if you have any questions, let us know as well.
We're going to catch up
on some comments. So Ed's in the house.
He's a Mind Power Breakthrough alumni.
What's up, Ed?
He's also going to be joining us in our Mind Power Coaching Academy next year in March.
So he said, I'm still in gratitude from the Mind Power Breakthrough. Breakthrough's still happening. Congrats. I love that. He's been smiling for a month. All I do is look up. Yeah. Love it. Love it. Love it. Good job.
I can't laugh out loud. That's why, since I'm under your coaching, Stéph and Shay, I can't get upset with my dementia patient at work. Laugh out loud. I'm very happy every day. Some nurses thought I'm such a nice person.
Aw, that's so great.
That is awesome.
That's great. Mindy Miller asks, do you ever have mornings that you don't feel like doing it? She's probably talking about the morning routine. If so, how do you overcome that?
Yeah, well, for me, I always feel like doing it. Sometimes I don't. And the days I don't, I feel like shiitake.
The days we don't do it.
I can tell.
When we skip
My day never goes like I fully want it to when I skip my morning routine.
Look, you know,
by the way, this is different than blah, by the way, so everybody knows.
Yeah, the question came up, so we were addressing it. Sometimes it's, you know, it's not the full length version. If I don't feel like it, at least I just start pumping my hands up and down and breathing. And that already in itself gets me out of the funk of not wanting to do it. Right.
And then you end up doing it.
Exactly. Yep. So try that of just start, right, without overthinking why you don't want to do it. And then just notice how it will overtake and get you into a positive state.
Stacy Poe Fritz, anytime I have anxiety lately, I have been thinking of stuff I'm grateful for, and it takes the anxiety away. Cool.
That's awesome.
Sweet.
Andy had to jump.
Cool.
So Dom came in on his phone. Hey, Dom.
Hey, Dom.
Perfect. Stacy says the method would be great for students who panic through tests.
Oh, yeah.
Totally.
I mean, this is a big part of our 1 million kids campaign, literally is making a positive impact on the lives of as many kids as possible, because they're the future of our planet.
So Tegan, listen
up. They're
our
future.
Take the blah method. Go to, you know, kids who right before their SATs or
teach it to them.
Finals or whatever.
They'll do better.
Yeah. Make that a whole part of your coaching business.
Stacy says definitely we'll use this. Laura said
love this.
Awesome. Dom says definitely going to use it. Danielle says, I learned something so useful. I can't wait to teach this to my husband who deals with anxiety. It works, literally.
Cool.
I used to deal with anxiety, and the blah method, we created it to help us.
Yes.
And I probably had more anxiety than Shay did. She's a little bit more even keeled, and I'm a little bit more hot blooded, probably the Latin blood of my family. And just saying,
we call it passion.
We call it passion. But seriously, so I struggled with anxiety for a while, and the blah method, we created originally for us and clients, and then it became a key component of our book.
Yeah.
So let's see. Cool said, thank you. Love it. Yes. Super beneficial. I'll be using it. The simplicity of the blah method is very simple, by the way, and it'll happen fast. It shouldn't, like, literally, I'm going to do a blah right now. Watch. Let's say I'm in stress.
So he's breathing, doing the box breath in through his nose, holding out, and he's looking up, And he's probably repeating the mantra, calm, relaxed, and in control in his head. And continuing the breathing. So once you get the steps down and you're no longer thinking about what you're doing, then you can start repeating the mantra. And now he's in gratitude. Awesome. I felt that.
Cool.
Nice.
How long did that take?
Oh, gosh. 30 seconds.
Less than a minute.
Yeah.
True or not true? Put in the chat room if that was less than a minute. Felt like an eternity for me because I was like in the void.
So many things were happening
for you. Cool. So yeah. So seriously, it's that fast. Like, just like that.
Yes.
And you'll pop out of stress. You'll pop out of anxiety. You'll pop out of overwhelm.
Loris says use box breathing to help fall asleep. Yep.
Yeah. Perfect. What you can do is you can use just the box breathing portion before sleep, but lengthen the time on the sides, right? So like inch it up to like 4 seconds aside, five seconds aside, six seconds aside.
The longer you go, we always start with three because it's new for people.
It's homeostatic. It'll get you to a homeostasis.
If you're already advanced in breathing or you're practicing and you're getting better at it, then go longer and it will really calm you and really lower your blood pressure and your heart rate.
Yeah.
The longer seconds you hold.
Tegan says, I love this method so much. I'll definitely be using it every day. Paul Jensen, shiitake.
shiitake happens.
Yep. Activate meditation becomes part of my routine in the morning. It's so easy.
Cool.
Yeah. Alicia, yes, I plan to use it. The most beneficial is looking up and seeing peripheral vision.
Nice.
That's huge.
Good.
Yes, I'll definitely be using it in my coaching business. True. Yes. True. Laura said 7 minutes.
#7 minutes.
Okay. Was I in the void for 7 minutes?
I don't know.
Oh, he might be talking about the morning routine.
Maybe.
Morning routine is nine minutes. It's 3x3, 1 minute per part. That's definitely 9 minutes, which could be done in 7 minutes.
Yeah.
Maybe that's what he's talking about. But the blah should literally take less than a minute.
Yeah.
Mindy says, I love that you give us ways to practically apply this information as opposed to just talking.
Awesome.
It's kind of our style.
Yeah.
Thanks for the feedback, Mindy. That's kind of our style.
We want you to actually be able to go out and use it and not, you know, talking doesn't always get you there. So
okay, so you have got to check this out on a computer. Got to check this out. A Los Rancho. Yes, yes, my man. I totally remember that. Yeah, that was a running parachute release. You remember that? Where they let go of a major running parachute in 7 minutes.
Got it.
Love you, brother. I love it. I totally remember. So
check out in the chats. We just dropped a link. It's masteryourmindpower.com/resources.
This is a secret site.
So,
I have to tell you, this is a secret site.
This is a top secret site that some of you, let us know if anyone's found this. I know Carrie Hall did because she put the graphic up on
she did.
On social media. But this is,
this is...
Literally, there's PDF visuals and handouts that you can download and have. Let's scroll through what's there. So we've got these are all visuals that are from the book. There's
all of the images from the book. That's maybe not as exciting if you have the book, but if you have only the audiobook, then you'll want them.
Yeah.
Our morning routine for mental toughness, the activation meditation, the whole guide on how to do that's there.
There's a sheet for
a sheet that you can print out for your 100
wants
challenge.
The Mindpower planning system.
Our Mindpower planning system. We talk about how to use that in module 5 of Mindpower Breakthrough.
And then there's
the blah method.
So if you want visuals, maybe if you're teaching this to your kids and you want to show them something, you could use that.
Watch, I'm going to download it so that we can share it. This is what it looks like. And then literally you can click the download button, right?
Yeah.
It's got visuals, little pictures, what's the importance of each one. Super cool. What else do we have in here? I'm like stoked.
I don't know.
Oh, these are exercises from our book.
This is like a surprise for me. I don't know.
This is a secret vault. Seriously. The only people that know about it are individuals who've read our book or listened to our audiobook.
If you know, you know.
If you know, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So anyway, check it out. We put it in the chat room. Let's do some giveaways. Make sure you put your name into the chat room.
Oh, there it is.
Yep. Make sure you put your name in the chat room if you want the giveaway. Remember, we're going to be giving away a shirt, a journal, a audiobook, and Session with Jades.
That's right.
Session with Jades.
Yes.
So cool.
I'm falling down.
Danielle says, I hope you guys go to Alasa Ranch next year. Hey, speak to your leaders.
Yeah, we hope so too.
We hope so too. If invited,
let them know you loved it. We'll
probably come.
Of results out of it, and
We've already brainstormed that probably we'd do some extra special stuff next year because to amp it up even more. Definitely some breakthroughs and some more practical strategies and stuff too that are really good in business. So definitely tell your leaders. Thanks for that, Danielle.
Yeah, thank you.
Definitely mention that to your leaders.
We'd love to come back.
So cool. Who else we got? You got Paulie. You got Alex. Ruffin. You got an Alex who's under Fifi Barlow. Who's Alex? Do we know Alex?
I think that's
brother.
Kenzie's brother.
Kenzie's brother. Oh, yeah. Cool.
From
Cindy Jensen.
Dominic.
She's like me. Okay, cool. Loris. Alicia.
Alex. Mindy.
Did you get Cindy? Did you get Alicia? Did you get
Loris?
Alicia? Let me call it out real quick again from the top. I've got Sam. You look over here. Sam, Kenzie, Stacy, Tegan, Paul, McKee, Danielle, Paul, Jay, Misty, Ephraim, Dominic. Let's see. Alex, Mindy, Cindy, Loris, Alicia.
Got it.
Okay, let's do
All
it.
All right. Anyone else? Speak now or forever. Forever hold your peace.
And if you're on, because we broadcast everywhere, if we don't see you in the chat room, we're so sorry.
Yeah, we're not seeing LinkedIn right
now. Probably got a bunch of people listening there.
Connecting there. Okay. So we're sorry.
So what we're going to do is first we're giving away the
journal.
Journal. We're going to do the journal first.
Da-da-da.
Okay, so let's get that puppy up there. We got to get the drum roll. Who's going to win the journal?
Uh-oh. Where's our screen?
Wait a second.
Oh, no. Hold on.
Wait.
We're having some technical
glitch.
There we go.
Okay. Bear with us. Here we go.
Okay.
Take two.
Here
we go.
Who's going to
be?
Journal.
Who's going to be? Loris gets a journal.
Woo!
Cool.
Congrats.
Success Training Company.
Congrats.
It's the company we founded 12 years ago.
Yes.
Our parent company.
This is just like the Master Your Mind Power journal, so you have a backup that you can use for.
You've got a red one.
Other things.
And a blue one.
Oh. Erica just.
She just joined.
In. And okay. Veronica Ramirez. Okay, put in.
Okay.
Let me get back.
Here you go.
All right.
So Veronica with a K.
And Erica with a K. Cool. You both just like popped in at the same time. That's great.
Super cool. Okay, cool. IKA.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, so what's up next, boss?
The t-shirt.
Okay.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, so we'll be, watch out.
Okay.
We'll be giving away the t-shirt. Are we giving away short sleeve or long sleeve? Choice.
Choice. Yes, your choice.
Short sleeve or long sleeve, as long as we've got the size.
As long as sizes are available.
Long sleeve may not be available. Okay, good. So, Erica says, I've been here.
Okay. It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, we saw you earlier.
That's right. Okay. Well, okay. We didn't know if she jumped.
I know.
You never know. That's why we
sometimes.
Have to collect names at the very end,
yes.
Right? Anyway, we're glad you're here. Okay, you're in the hunt.
Yes.
Okay, you're in the hunt. So let's do this. Okay, for the shirt.
Shirt gonna be Danielle. Woo! Congratulations. Awesome.
I personally recommend the short sleeve because it's very good year round.
It is.
Especially because she doesn't have a shirt yet. Usually long sleeve for individuals that already have the short
sleeve.
But anyway, you'll have to, whoever communicates with you from our team, you'll have to let them know what you want. I do recommend short sleeve because it's great year round.
You could always put long sleeve under it if you want.
You could. It's a style.
But
totally up to you.
Yeah.
Totally up to you. So, okay.
Cool.
Veronica's putting her name in again.
Got you, Veronica.
We got you, Veronica.
Yep, we got you.
Okay. Next, the audiobook.
So this is going to be, we're going to get, our team's going to send you a code and a website you go to. And you know, if you don't have an account there already because it's audiobooks.com.
You just have to sign up for
an account.
One. But then
you get a free credit for a free.
Mark Ferguson is in the house. Hello, Mr. Ferguson. Hello. Okay, cool. So here we go.
This is for a complimentary audiobook of Master Your Mind Power.
Here we go. Kenzie!
Yay! Congratulations.
Congratulations. She already has the audiobook.
Right. So you can gift it.
You can gift it to somebody.
Yeah.
As a Christmas gift.
Totally.
As a holiday gift or as a New Year's gift or a Kwanzaa gift. Whatever. Very, very cool. Okay. Finally, a coaching session with Jada.
Yes. A 30-minute coaching session with Jada. The amazing Jada.
All good, Mr. Ferguson. We're just grateful that you're here. Super, super grateful. And you can watch the replay. Okay, sweet. So now here we go. Last but not least.
There's gonna be
free coaching session with Jada.
Erica!
Yay!
Congrats.
My winner, chicken dinner. Good job.
Awesome.
Okay.
Erica, FYI, look out for communication on Facebook. I believe you're on Facebook. I'm pretty sure you are. Just because our team can't communicate with you on the back channels of YouTube, right? So it'll be on Facebook.
Yeah, check out on Facebook.
Yeah, and they'll be in touch with you. So
that's a wrap for tonight.
Yeah. Oh, super.
Stay with us. This is important.
Super important. So mark your calendars. Write this down right now.
For the next live.
This is our last live of this year.
Yes.
We're going to be taking some time off. And so our next one is January 5th.
Mark your calendar.
And we are changing the time by 30 minutes. It's going to start 30 minutes later so that all of our group calls, everything we do for us is at 6:30 Mountain.
Easier for us to know where we're at. Also,
we
got feedback from our membership that
on the West Coast,
on the West Coast, that it would help them if it could be budged forward, because for them, this was starting at 5 and they were just leaving work. And
right.
Sometimes doing it in the car and not able to listen
in. So now it will start at 5:30 Pacific, 8:30 Eastern, and whatever is in between. So we're just bumping
it. If you show up at the old time, you're going to show up a little early. No one's going to be here.
Right.
So schedule, put it in your calendar. January 5th.
January 5th.
If you have a recurring entry in your calendar, you might want to remove it or revise it.
Right.
Starting January 5th, it'll go every other week from there at
5:30
Pacific, 6:30 Mountain, 7:30 Central, 8:30 Eastern.
And then, you know, fill in the blanks wherever else you are located.
Yep.
So awesome. We look forward to seeing you on January 5th. And that is going to be our signature year in review process.
Ooh.
It's what we've been doing for the last 10 years. It's what we believe has helped us, a big part of our success in what we do big picture. We close out the year before. And
that's key.
Which
launches you into the next year.
Launch you into the new year. So
Shay and I don't believe in resolutions.
Mm-mm.
What is it? 80% of them fail by February.
Yep.
So the reality is we're going to teach you how to be in the 1% of the individuals who are always succeeding. They don't set resolutions. They set big effing goals. And the way that they set these big frickin' goals is by first reviewing the past year in a certain way and going through this 3-part process that really sets you up for success for the year ahead. So make sure you're there. This is huge, huge, such an important one. And then we'll be back on every other week from there.
Yeah.
Which is super exciting.
So we wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We love all of you.
Love all of you.
Stay healthy, happy, much love, and we'll see
much
you on the
other
side.
Much wealth and prosperity to you and all the things, and that every day and every way you're better and better and you're totally healthy and you're totally strong, and that you have a wonderful end of the year. And remember to keep finishing strong if you own a business.
That's right. And remember that you're mastering your mind power.
Okay. Much love.
All right.
See ya. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.